not used? Watch out.
You want some used? Find his girlfriend.
Well, at least mine isn't a ride at Disneyland. She's an e-ticket, though.
E-ticket, yeah, that's 40 people or more.
Wait just a minute. We gotta do this one more time. Ladies and gentlemen, the dude is disgusting. The salt is so fucked. We gotta keep a musical comedy. Oh, Ryan McDonald.
In because you still got the box that the cherry came in.
defense of all.
That's so nice.
I did it at all.
I did it twice.
Last night, I stayed awake to masturbate. It felt so good.
It felt so good.
I knew it would.
I knew it would.
Oh, yours. And she'd been working on the short strokes. It's really grand.
It's really grand.
I used my hand.
I used my hand.
So you. She's seen me working on the long strokes.
It's really neat.
It's really neat.
I use it my feet.
He uses his feet. Mash it, mash it. Beat it on the floor. Bite it, ram it through the door. Oh, it's so neat to be your mate while sitting on the toilet seat. He's a nice and fine, but such a jerk of all the time. Hey!
She sat on the grass. She pulled up her dresses and showed us her ruffles and laces and a white fluffy duck. Quack! She said she was learning a new way to bring up her children and learn them to knit. While the boys in the barnyard were shoveling refuse and litter from yesterday's hunt. While the girl in the meadow was rubbing her eyes at the fellows, as girls sometimes do, to make it quite clear that she wanted to go for a nice pleasant stroll on the grass and hurry back home for a nice piece of ice cream and cake that stood three layers tall. And after dessert, she was ready to go for another walk down by the dock with any young man with a sizable roll of 100s and a big bulge up front. If he'd ask politely, she'd show him her little pet dog who was subject to fits. And maybe she'd let him grab hold of her small tender hands with a movement so quick. Then she'd bend on over and suck on his soda so sweetly till she finished it. Then pull down her panties to rub on her hip that she bruised when she ran down the halls. Cause he tried to force her to lick on his candy so tasty made of butterscotch. And then he spread whipped cream all over her cookies that she had been baking all night. If you think this is dirty, you're fucking welcome.
Like some of those cheaper spreads I've eaten. So I mustered up my courage and I whispered, hey mama bird, you got a sweet set of sesame seed buns and I'd love to bury my open face in your McMuffin snack pack. And maybe later on I could drive in my jumbo jack in your box. What's your name anyway? Wendy, she replied. And that her buns were always hot and fresh. Well, seemed like an invitation to me, so I unzipped my French fly, pulled down my hash browns, and whipped out my quarter pounder. She took one look at my foot-long wiener schnitzel and screamed, holy enchilada, what a whopper! Seen a sausage and a pair of McNuggets like that since I was in a sack with Long John Silver and Captain Kidd over at the Colonel's place. And I probably won't see another till Foster freezes over. And believe me, I relish the thought of squeezing the mayonnaise right out of that big sloppy Joe ears. I said, look, honey, those meatheads are just horseradish. I'm the supreme burger king around here. By the way, aren't you hungry? Yeah, she shot back. I haven't even had my breakfast, Jack. It wasn't long before she was munching on my Big Mac and eventually took down the whole enchilada. I could tell I wouldn't be able to hold the pickles or hold the lettuce much longer, so I just blew a whole bucket of my locale secret sauce to go. She took a big gulp and screamed, "Ooh, that's fast food." A bit salty, but quality you can taste. And finger looking good, too. She said, so what's your name, hot dog? Orange you Julius? I said, no, Bob. But you can call me Pizza Man, because I deliver. Well, anyway, I turned her around, tore off her wrapper, and wedged my big boy between her patties and right up into her hot cherry bend over. She screamed, "I found the beef! I found the beef!" Which just gave me the urge to continue pounding my super burrito in and out, and in and out, and in and out of her hot little micro. Still playing Pop and Taco. But she confessed her real name wasn't Wendy, but Ronald. Hey, it wasn't my bag, but at least I didn't have to worry about taking her over to see Dr. Pepper and having him pull a Carl's Jr. out of her oven. Yeah, little did I know that I had spent the night not with a saucy little fish fillet, but with a flaming Dairy Queen.
Boy, I'd walk a mile for that vertical smile.
Oh, that's a nice dress she's almost wearing there.
Good God. Boy, a woman's place is on a man's face, as far as we're concerned.
Why do they call me Bonnerville?
Oh, boy.
When we first met, you were very shy. You said I was the only guy to show you things you never knew before. But you got into loving it. You started screaming,
"Please don't quit."
But darling, now my face is getting sore. How can I say I love you when I can't even breathe down here? 'Cause it's so hard to talk to you. Watch TV or have a couple beers. How can I say I love you when I can't even breathe out here?
Well, darling, it wasn't long before you changed. You got into whips and chains, and every night you start begging me for more and more.
Oh, more.
You ordered me to be your slave, to do the things you always crave. But please don't tell me what that vacuum cleaner attachment is for. That's gonna hurt me. That's gonna hurt me.
How can I say I love you when I can't even breathe down here? 'Cause it's so hard to talk to you with your thighs wrapped around my ears. Why can't we just watch TV or have a couple of beers? Say I love you when I can't even breathe down here.
I can't see Jack Dingo down here.
How can I say I love you when I can't even say it down here?
You said a mouthful, honey.
Okay, well, we've got a brand new person here. He's challenging Dr. Ruth for her position as a sexual therapist because we have Dr. Leroy Buster Hyman. That's right, he's from the ghetto. And he's going to give you the latest sexually speaking helpful hints right now. So let's find out what's happening with Dr. Leroy Buster Hyman.
So, it's Dr. Leroy Buster Hyman. What we're going to do is answer some questions from people right now all over the country. People are saying, Dr. Leroy, I got myself a problem. I guess I know they wouldn't be talking to me, you know what I'm saying? So they're writing in some questions. This dude's going to read off a few of them. I'm going to give you some real answers. Now, I'm not going to bullshit you. I'm going to tell you like it is. I'm laying it down flat, you know what I'm saying? So it's time to take a pill and chill out, you know what I'm saying? Because we're going to be cool on this. All right, read some questions, I'll get some answers.
Okay, Dr. Leroy Buster Hyman, we have question number one from one of our viewers out there. This is a tough one. Dear Dr. Leroy, I enjoy being spread-eagled over the hood of a 58 Chevy pickup truck by four Hells Angels and have my clitoris stimulated by a high-speed Black & Decker belt sander. My husband appears to be jealous. What should I do? Writes Wanda Whippet from Rawhide, Wyoming.
Well, Wanda, I'm not surprised. And what you gotta do to get your man from being jealous, you gotta get him in on the party. So have him hold the high-speed Black & Decker belt sand every once in a while. And if he digs it, then spin him around and ground his ass down a little bit.
Thank you, Dr. Leroy. Question number two, Dr. Leroy. Peter Purvey, who writes from Maidenhead, Massachusetts, states, I'm a 54-year-old male who has a constant craving for 16-year-old girls. Is there anything wrong with this?
Peter, the only thing wrong with that is that Jake ain't 14.
Thank you, Leroy.
That's right. I'll go where it is, you know what I'm saying?
Third question, Dr. Leroy. Karen Cornhole, who hails from Brown Eye, Texas.
I know you're making this shit up now.
Says, Dear Dr. Leroy, my husband insists on anal sex twice a week. I find it very painful. How do you feel about this?
Well, Karen, that's bullshit, because I did to my old lady all the time, and I don't think it hurts me at all. I feel fine when I'm doing it, you know what I'm saying?
Very sensitive, Dr. Leroy. Question.
Hey, you know why it takes a woman so long to reach an orgasm? I don't.
Okay, here's another tough one. Debbie Dumpster, who lives in Bigelow, Louisiana, inquires, I am a member of a Weight Watchers who has oral sex with my husband 6 times a day. Do I have to worry about taking in too many calories?
This is a question we get a lot. The people that are on diet, they run into this all the time. See, now, the thing is, this depends on if the dude is white or black. Now, if the cat is white, we're talking about a snack, and you're only going to put on a couple, 3 calories. If the brother's black, we're talking about a banquet, you're going to get fat real fast, baby. Know what I'm saying?
Smorgasbord of love, I think.
That's right.
Here's another tough question. Rosie Rottencrotch from Fish Creek, Michigan. And she asks, is it true that black males possess larger genitalia than their Caucasian counterparts? Excuse me.
Rosie, you got a TV? Check this sucker out. See, that's my answer, Rosie. See, you ain't gonna find that on Donny Osmond, you know what I'm saying?
Pretty big walker there, Dr.
That's
Leroy.
Right. That's right.
Okay, question. Here's another question. It's a tough one. Paula Pureway, living in Missionary, Missouri, writes in, my boyfriend insists that we join a local swingers club for group sex. However, I feel that love between two people is still a wonderful, beautiful thing. What do you think?
Well, that's true, baby. Love between two people is a beautiful thing. But love between 11 people is outrageous, mama. Get that boy in a hot tub and start partying. Damn.
Okay, here's a kinky question from the edges of sexual problems. This is on the outer limits. All right. Ricky Mortis, who claims White Slab, South Dakota, as his home, complains, owning a mortuary affords me the opportunity to work with many beautiful but deceased women.
Mm-hmm.
However, my clients regard my sexual relationships with their loved ones as immoral. Are they right?
Well, see, here's what I got to say about that. See, Ricky, if the bitch is dead, you ain't gonna get no head. Remember that.
Dr. Leroy!
Maybe now!
In his brand new regular jeans. He's got a bleach blonde bomber and she looks like a barroom queen. He's got a beer gut belly, but he walks tall and proud.
And if you try to get smart with him, he'll punch you out. He kicks ass, he pumps gas. He'd rather drink a can of Bud than smoke some grass. He pokes steers in the rear when he's looking for a piece of ass. He drives a pickup truck. He loves to he wears an old t-shirt that says disco sucks. He's an all-American redneck. He's got class.
Well, he just bought a brand new rifle with a match in the rack. He loves to go horizontal dancing with a little sheep out back. He's got all the latest up to western hits.
And loves Dolly Parton cause she's got Gigantor.
That's right.
He kicks ass, he pumps gas. He'd rather drink a can of Bud than smoke some grass. He pokes steers in the rear when he's looking for a piece of ass. He drives a pickup truck. He loves to wears an old t-shirt that says disco sucks. He's an all-American redneck. He's got class. He kicks ass. He pumps gas. He'd rather drink a can of Bud and then smoke some grass. He pokes steers in the rear when he's looking for a piece of ass. Oh, he drives a pickup truck. He loves to wears an old t-shirt that says disco sucks. He's an all-American redneck. He's got class. He's an all-American redneck. He's got class.
He'll kick your ass. Yeah. All right, let's do it.
Being a Mr. Goodbar. So when I saw Ms. Hershey standing behind the powerhouse on the corner of Clark and Fifth Avenue, I whipped out my whopper and whispered, "Hey, sweetheart, how'd you like to crunch up my big hug for $1 million bar? But she immediately went down in my Tootsie Roll. You know, it was like pure almond joy. I couldn't help but grab her delicious mounds, cause it was easy to see that this little twix had the red eyes. It was all I could do to hold back a snicker and a cracker. It was my butterfinger when I perked tight the Kit Kat and she started to scream, "Oh, Henry! Oh, Henry!" Soon she was fondling with my Peter Paul and Zag Nuts, and I knew it wouldn't be long before I blew my milk duds clear to Mars and gave her a taste of the old Milky Way. She asked if I was into M&M's. I said, "Hey, chicken, no geeky stuff." I said, "Look, you little Reese piece, don't be a zero, be a lifesaver. Why don't you just take my whatchamacallit and scuff it up your bit of honey?" Ooh, what a piece of juicy fruit she was, too. She screamed, "Oh, Cracker Jack, you're better than the Three Musketeers!" As I ran with my ding-dong up her rocky road and into her peanut butter cup. While I was giving it to her good and plenty, all of a sudden, my starburst. Yes, luck would have it, she started to grow a bit chunky and complained of a wriggly in her stomach. Sure enough, 9 months later, up popped a baby Ruth.
Started to think,
face. She's got that motel face.
She's got the motel face.
She's got that hotel face.
She's got the hotel face.
So well, tomorrow you look like hell.
Tonight you look swell.
Well, there ain't nothing like waking up to that motel face.
Songs. I packed my guitar.
She was right around the corner. We took her car, and when we got there, she opened the door. We both knew what we came for, and then we rolled around on the bathroom floor.
We beat the orthopedic till a quarter to four.
She's got that motel face.
She's got the motel face.
She's got that hotel face.
She's got the hotel face.
Well, tomorrow you look like hell.
Tonight you look swell.
Well, there ain't nothing like waking up to that motel face. A little Dixie.
Place.
I found my pants sitting on a chair.
I found my jock strap stuck in her hair.
She's got that motel face.
She's got the motel face.
She's got that motel face.
She's got the motel face.
So well, tomorrow you look like hell.
Tonight you look swell.
Well, there ain't nothing like waking up to the motel face.
Ugly, ugly.
In his pants till I had enough, so just for revenge, I went and named him Sue. It was Gatlinburg in mid-July. I was getting drunk and getting by and getting old and going from bad to worse. Went through the door with an awful scream, comes the ugliest queen I've ever seen, and he says,
"Hi, my name is Sue, how do you do?"
And then he hit me with his purse. Ain't the way he tells the tale, but he scratched my face with his fingernail, bit my thumb, and kicked me with his high-heeled shoes.
I can be a tiger.
I punched him in the nose, and he started to cry. He threw some perfume in my eye. Sure, an easy fight with a boy named Sue.
I could be an animal.
I whacked him on the head with a table and a chair to scream.
Hey, Dad, you messed my hair.
Then he kicked me in the navel and knocked out a piece of my lid. I was spitting blood, he was spitting teeth. He crashed the wall out into the street, kicking and gouging in the mud and the blood in his green demeanor. In out of his panties, he pulls a gun. I'm about to get shot by my very own son. He's screaming about Sigmund Freud, looking green.
I have problems.
I thought fast, holding some stuff. I named him Sue just to make him tough. And I guess he bought it, cause now I'm living with him. He kicks and sews, cleans out the place, cuts my hair, shaves my face, irons my shirts better than a daughter could do.
I'm so domestic.
And all the nights that I can't score, well, you know, I can't tell you anymore, but sure the joy you have a boy like Sue. Yeah, some is fun, but it's a real joy with Sue.
That hurts, Dan.
So I'm telling it all to you.
I've been jacking up, beating my meat.
You left me and I'm in need.
What else can I do?
Cause my dreams are just getting true.
I've been jacking up, committing penicide.
No variation of nothing tried.
What else can I do?
Cause I'm jacking up over you. There's been some horny women in strange places, wearing cheap feeling and pale faces. They're all one to screw, yeah, but no one else will do. So you take them out and you play the game. You fuck them once, they want to know your name. Fuck them twice, or they want your love to.
So I've been jacking off, slamming the ham,
choking the chicken,
and jamming the spam. What else can I do?
Yeah, my wet dreams are just came true.
I've been jacking off, committing penicide.
No variation I haven't tried.
What else can I do?
Cause I'm checking out for you.
Don't worry, baby, I don't mind. Even though my palms are hairy and I'm going blind, I'm a practical man. I got the solution right in my hand.
I've been licking the pillow, creaming the sheets.
Good God, I've even tried to use my feet. Now give me the soap.
Okay. I need more Vaseline. I've been jacking up, polishing the law, jerking the turkey and flogging the dog. What else can I do?
Cause my wet dreams are just getting true.
I've been jacking up, committing penicide.
A shop of cinema.
His name was Leroy. He was not like me or you. Just laying back and getting high was all he cared to do. As a kid, he sat in the cellar sniffing airplane glue. And then he smoked banana peels when that was the thing to do. He tried aspirin and Coca-Cola. He breathed helium on the sly. And his life became an endless search to find the perfect high. Grass just made him want to eat chocolate chip pizza all night. And the things that he wrote while he was stoned looked like shit in the morning light. Speed just made him rap all day. Reds laid him too far back. Cocaine Rose was sweet to his nose, but the price nearly broke his back. He tried PCP, he tried THC, but they didn't quite do the trick. Poppers nearly blew his heart, and mushrooms made him sick. Acid made him see the light, but he didn't remember it long. Hash was a little too weak, and smack was a lot too strong. Quaaludes made him stumble, and booze just made him cry. And then he heard of a cat named Baba Fats, who knew the perfect high. Now, Baba Fats was a hermit cat. He lived high up in Nepal, high on a craggy mountaintop, up a sheer and icy wall.
But help, says Leroy. I'm a healthy boy, and I'll climb, fly, until I find me the guru who will give me the clue is the woods the perfect high.
Out and off goes Leroy to a land that knows no time. Up a trail no man could conquer, to a cliff no man could climb. And for 14 years he'd climb that cliff, and back down again he'd slide. And he'd sit, and he'd cry, and he'd climb some more, pursuing the perfect eye. Grinding his teeth, coughing blood, aching and shaking and weak, bleeding and sore. Starving and torn, he reaches the mountain peak. His eyes blink red like a snowblind wolf, and he snarls the snarl of a rat. For there in repose, and wearing no clothes, sits the godlike Baba Fats.
"What's happening, Fats?"
says Leroy.
I've come to state my biz. Now I hear you're hip to the perfect trip. Please tell me what it is. For you can see,
said Leroy D,
here I'm about to die. And for my last ride, please tell me how I can achieve the perfect high.
Well, dog my cats,
said Baba Fats.
It's just another burned out soul who's looking for an alchemist to change his trip to gold. It isn't in a dealer's stash or on a druggist's shelf. Son, if you must find the perfect high, well, find it in yourself.
You die, motherfucker,
said Leroy.
I climbed through rain and sleet. Now I froze 3 fingers off my hands and 4 toes off my feet. I braved the lair of the polar bear, and I tasted the maggot's kiss. Now you tell me the highs within myself. Now what kind of shit is this? Now my ears, before they froze off,
said Leroy,
had heard all kinds of crap. But I didn't climb up here to hear that the highs on the ledge. No, I didn't climb for 14 years to hear this kind of crap. Now you tell me where the real stuff is, I'll kill you, guru ass.
Oh, okay, okay,
said Baba Fats.
You're forcing it out of me. Now there is a land beyond the sun. It's known as Zeboni. It's a wretched land of stone and sand where snakes and buzzards scream. And in that devil's garden blooms the mystic Zutsu tree. Where once in every 100 years, it blooms a single flower as white as the Key West skies. And he who eats of that pure white flower shall know of the perfect high. For the rush, it comes on like a tidal wave, and it hits like the blazing sun. And the high, it lasts forever. And the down, well, it don't never come. But Zaboli land is ruled by a giant who stands 12 cubits high, and with eyes of red and 100 heads, he waits for the passers-by. And you must kill the red-eyed giant and swim the river of slime, where the mucus beasts await to feast on those who journey by. And if you kill the giant and beast and swim the slimy sea, there's a blood-drinking witch who sharpens her teeth as she guards the Zutsu tree.
Well, hell with the witches and giants,
said Leroy.
Hell with the beasts of the sea, because as long as the Zutsu flower still blooms, hope still blooms for me.
So with tears of joy in his sunburned eyes, Leroy slips the guru a 5. And he climbs off and down the mountainside, pursuing the perfect high.
Well, that is that,
said Baba Fats, sitting back down on his stone, basing another 1,000 years of talking to God alone.
Yes, Lord, it's all the same, old man or bright-eyed youth. It's always easier to sell them some shit than it is to tell them the truth.
driving down the freeway the other day. Some little jerk off cut me right off my lane. I knew there wasn't anything I could do about it, so I wrote a song. It goes like this: Where are you born, an asshole? Or did you practice your whole life? Either way, it worked out fine, 'cause you're an asshole tonight. Well, your name is S-H-O-L-E, and don't you try to blame it on me. You deserve all the credit, 'cause you're an asshole tonight. You were an asshole yesterday, you're an asshole tonight. And I got this feeling, you'll be an asshole the rest of your life. I told her I thought you were an asshole. She said, yes, I think you're right. And all your friends are assholes, 'cause you've known them your whole life. And somebody told me, you got an asshole for a wife. Were you born an asshole, or did you practice your whole life? Worked out fine, 'cause you're an asshole tonight.
Relics with the Dukes of Disgusting. So I hope you guys like that. Definitely some dirty shit. So make sure you like, favorite, and subscribe, and comment. Let me know what your favorite song was. Relic out.
Rise from your grave.
A humanoid must not escape in spite like a robot.